Belknap Street in Superior, Wisconsin is both a principal arterial roadway and an oversized overweight truck route. It connects the Wisconsin US Highway 2, US 2, and US 53 corridors with Minnesota. This segment of roadway is an important part of Wisconsin's transportation network, especially to area residents, businesses, and visitors. Due to a lack of underground roadway drainage on Belknap Street, the existing concrete pavement has been compromised to a degree that requires reconstruction to correct. The Belknap Street project is being scheduled due to this pavement deterioration. The proposed 1.4-mile project will begin just west of the Banks Avenue and Belknap Street intersection, continue east on Belknap Street, and end just past the intersection of Hill Avenue. This proposed project includes improvements along US 2 and on most of the connecting side streets, back to the respective alleys north and south of US 2. Reconstruction of the roadway will include improved roadway safety and access. Safety solutions of the redesigned roadway will provide for local business traffic and pedestrian usage needs. These include designated left turn bays, bus turnouts, spot pedestrian safety medians, and curb extensions. A raised safety median will be utilized near the rail corridor. Additional left turn lanes will be added to better facilitate traffic mobility. All 7 existing signals from Banks Avenue to Hill Avenue will be replaced, as well as retimed for current and future traffic needs. Aesthetic treatments will include landscaping, benches, decorative lighting, and coloring and patterning of the concrete sidewalk and ornamental walls. A new storm sewer system, including underground roadway drainage and surface roadway drainage, will also be included in the project. Traffic impacts and detours. The US Highway 2 Belknap Street roadway is scheduled to be reconstructed over a 2-year period. It's currently planned to be constructed half at a time, with one lane open in each direction to minimize traffic impacts. Intermittent roadway closures may occur at locations of complex construction work to shorten the duration of construction time. Cross streets will remain open when feasible. Construction is planned to be broken into 3 portions across the 2-year period. Each roadway portion under construction will be open to local traffic with one lane of traffic in each direction. Construction is expected to begin in late April of 2017 and 2018. The roadway is expected to reopen during the fall of each year. Tentative completion dates for construction include late fall of 2017 and 2018. While construction is underway, a truck detour route and a vehicle detour route for through traffic will be utilized to reduce congestion and increase work zone safety during construction. This is the passenger vehicle detour route for both years of construction. Local business traffic could utilize parallel city streets. Belknap Street will have no on-street parking during construction. It is recommended that businesses utilize backdoor and alternative entrances wherever feasible. During 2017, the Duluth Transit Authority, or DTA, bus route will remain along Belknap Street with relocated temporary stops. However, during 2018, the DTA bus route will follow an alternative route on or near North 16th Street. Local traffic and pedestrians. This is an example of how construction traffic is planned to work throughout the project. The hatched area is the construction work zone. The traffic would run counter-directional, with one lane moving in each direction. Staging begins with traffic on the north side and construction on the south side throughout the project. Due to most of the utility work occurring in the first stage of construction each year, this is the traffic configuration that is expected to last the longest. During the shorter, second stage of construction each year, local through traffic shifts to the south side of Belknap on the new pavement. During the final stage of the construction project each year, vehicles would occupy normal traffic lanes, albeit with only one lane open in each direction. The contractor may change which lane traffic uses to accommodate safer and more efficient construction work on the median and roadsides. The entire roadway is scheduled to reopen each fall. In general, the Wisconsin Department of Transportation allows construction between the hours of 6 a.m. and 10 p.m. There are some occasions where earlier or later work could be approved on a case-by-case basis. Work may occur up to 7 days a week. WSDOT is planning for weekend closures of US 2 through traffic for installation of utilities. WSDOT is requiring the contractor to open the completed roadway each fall. Therefore, the planned closures are set up to give the contractor as much time as possible to complete the work. This is an example of how pedestrian traffic would travel through the project during both years of construction. Local vehicle traffic on Belknap Street is shown in the 2 lanes on the south side of the street. The hatched area shows the construction work zone on a closed side street. In this example, pedestrians are encouraged to stay on the south side of the roadway and cross only when needing to access businesses and/or side streets. During both years of construction, pedestrian traffic through the work zone will require temporary sidewalk and business accesses. These temporary sidewalk and business accesses will be a minimum of 5 feet wide and be located outside the immediate work area. Please see the Traffic Impacts and Detours section of this video for information regarding adjustments to transit bus routes. Trucking and freight. WSTOT highly recommends truck and freight traffic use the following detour routes. These routes will be required for all loads not delivering within the project limits. A lane in each direction through the construction is expected to be available for local traffic and deliveries. Oversized, overweight multi-trip permits in the City of Superior will have additional restrictions due to construction. Multi-trip permitted loads over 125 feet long and over 52 tons will require a single-trip permit for the years of construction. During construction, long loads no wider than 10 feet may be able to get through the project in certain stages. No loads wider than 10 feet will be allowed through the project. Any loads over 125 feet long will require an alternate route that is not the detour. Construction effects and owner info. Construction activity can be disruptive, and the US-2 Belknap Street reconstruction project is no different. Dust, noise, and vibration will occur off and on throughout the project. Based on the temporary construction effects, WSTOT has placed some protective measures and construction protection strategies for buildings into the contract. WSTOT has included a vibration standard special provision instructing the contractor to monitor vibration along the project. Another standard special provision instructs the contractor to thoroughly inspect building structures for existing defects, including interior and exterior walls. The contractor will document general physical conditions with photographs and/or videos prior to construction activities. Post-construction inspections may also occur. One method WSTOT specifies to reduce vibration while removing concrete is to saw cut the concrete on a tight grid to remove the existing concrete. This may create a little more dust, but much less vibration than a standard concrete breaker. Routinely, WSTOT uses dust abatement measures on construction projects. During the environmental phase of design, WSTOT conducted a series of web searches while investigating construction around historic buildings. Suggestions for property owners include: install temporary floor coverings at entrances and consider sealing windows facing the construction site to limit dust infiltration. Remove dust from interior surfaces on an accelerated schedule. And clean HVAC systems and filters on an accelerated schedule. These are only suggestions. Each owner will need to decide what steps will best help their business or property. For example, if you experience dust in your building now, construction may only make it worse. Taking steps to better seal your windows may be what works best for your property. Additional suggestions include: clear obstructions from gutters and drainage systems regularly. Create revised emergency plans. WSTOT and the city have met with emergency service personnel to inform and review their needs for construction access during emergencies. Inform tenants on location of parking, access into building, and changes to emergency plans. Again, it is recommended that backdoor and alternative accesses be used when feasible throughout the construction process. Conduct a survey of existing conditions, including 35mm photographs, crack inventory, and description of other damage. Remove particularly fragile interior objects and furnishings from the property. Install temporary supports beneath fragile features that are not moved. Consider placing plywood coverings on delicate windows, doors, or openings that face the construction area. If construction is directly adjacent to your property, protect or cover delicate building facade. WSTOT recognizes businesses located in work zones have special needs. It is critical that customers have access to businesses and that they continue to visit them, regardless of any road work inconvenience. This program is offered to businesses and community leaders as an idea source as they plan for road construction in their area. Through communication and cooperation, businesses can not only survive, but thrive when road construction comes to town. For more information, visit the U.S. Highway 2 Belknap Street project website. The U.S. Highway 2 Belknap Street segment of roadway in Superior, Wisconsin is an important part of Wisconsin's transportation network. With your cooperation during this reconstruction process, an improved infrastructure can better serve the greater Superior area, neighboring communities, and the entire state for years to come.